So Simone Development Company is continuing to use his wealth and connections to the courts to abuse and harass me. At least that is my opinion on what's going on, and I will exercise my First Amendment right in keeping you guys aware of what is happening to me. So I was sent a cease and desist overnight from Cerulli Shanks and Zismore LLP, their attorneys on 420 Lexington Avenue, New York, New York. So they sent me a letter basically saying they were unhappy with me making that video last weekend, saying Simone Development Company sent two government agents and four cops to shut me down. A statement I made about the people that work for Simone Development Company. And also, when you rent real estate from Simone Development Company, they will do everything short of slitting your throat to destroy your business. It also seems like they want to impede my First Amendment right and shut me up and stop me from keeping people aware of what's happening to me and who's doing it. Now, someone sent a text message to someone at that company. I don't know who it is, but it wasn't me, and they're accusing me of doing it. The area code on the cell phone number they're giving me, I don't even know where that's from. But to my understanding, if someone watches a YouTube video and decides to text someone, it has nothing to do with me. I don't know why you're sending me a cease and desist. You are hereby reminded that on July 11, 2022, Honorable Verena Powell, JCC, directed in an open court to Frank DeFano that he immediately cease and desist from all communication with petitioner and that all communication between parties should be made through counsel. Be further advised that you should fail to immediately comply with all of your forgiving. Our client's intends to vigorously and promptly pursue any and all available remedies in law and in equity, all of which are hereby resolved in their entirety without prejudice. Guide yourselves accordingly. So basically, this is their lawyer threatening me, and they want me to shut up, and they don't want me to, you know, it's a free country. I can say what I want. This is nothing short of intimidation. And what was really bad was, when I went to see that judge on July 11th, this is another case. So I had filed a case in Supreme Court against Simone Development Company for harassment. They went to file a case in Bronx Civil Court against me to get me evicted. And now they have all these connections in the Bronx Civil Court. So they were able to get a court hearing within 1 week of filing the petition, which is unheard of because the courts are backed up. Years basically. And when I went to this hearing, which the judge came just for this hearing, okay, that's how connected these people are, I was basically intimidated by their lawyer and the judge. The judge wouldn't let me talk. It was a very one-sided thing. And the judge was even saying, like, oh, I could issue an arrest warrant. So it was nothing short of disgusting overreach and threatening me. This is nothing short. I'm being threatened by judges in a civil court that I can be arrested. That's what these people are doing to me. And after that, and then I post a video on what they're doing to my business, then they send me this. So this is nothing short. This is unbelievable. I don't know what these people think they're doing, but everything they do to me is going to be on my YouTube channel. This is completely ridiculous. I don't know what to do, guys. I don't know what to do. This is every single thing I worked for. I can't relocate, even if I could afford to. None of the lenders want to work with someone who has the lawsuits and the USDA federal issues. None of these government agencies are following any sort of protocol whatsoever. It's almost like they were told by someone to shut my business down. And for some reason, part of me still wants to try to stick it through and make it work, but this is unbelievable, guys. This is unbelievable. They're not following procedures. They're not doing anything correctly. My lawyer's not helping me.